Maayong buntag sa inyong lahat.
Good morning. All right. It's great to be here again. Alam nyo, ilang balik na ang Go Negosyo sa Cebu. But for me, it's the first time as the DTI Secretary to be here in Cebu. We had a very good late dinner last night thanks to our host, Kenneth Cobonfue. Kenneth, please stand up. Ikaw ang creative hero in Cebu, and not only in Cebu, in the Philippines. Special mention also to a long-time entrepreneurship advocate kasama mula nung nag-umpisa ang Go Negosyo, Mr. J. Aldeguer. Yan din ang hero ng mga entrepreneurs, especially the young ones. And since that was 11 years ago, that was, you were young ones before, no? Sige, ngayon na rin. Okay, good morning, Father Louis Punzalan. In behalf of Father Miranda, maraming salamat po for the partnership with the USC and Go Negosyo. I must recognize also the former Undersecretary of DTI, Undersecretary Merly Cruz. Hello, ma'am. Matagal na partner ng Go Negosyo nung siya po ang nasa DTI pa at ako ang nasa Go Negosyo. Ngayon po, we traded places. So, nasya na ngayon ang Go Negosyo as advisor. Thank you for accepting the invitation to help Go Negosyo. And I'm now with DTI. Now to my new DTI family, Regional Director Aster Caberte, and the Provincial Directors. Ayan. Let's congratulate DTI. Palakpakan natin ang Region 7. They won again as the best regions, regional office for DTI. Our U.S. Embassy partner, Mr. Cody Avila, in behalf of Pete Davis. Hello, good morning. U.S. Embassy and Go Negosyo has been partnering on this particular program called Youth Entrepreneurship Development Workshop, which started last year. And we've done a lot of workshops, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, able to touch and I guess improve the business models of many young entrepreneurs who joined the workshop. We'll discuss that in a few moments. Special mention also to our speakers, Paul Rivera, Mr. DeJoss, who will be helping us in the sessions today. Of course, again, long time angelpreneurs or mentors, Mr. Ping Soto, Vix Madlangbayan, Arman Benko, who, as you know, they've been helping Go Negosyo. Pag Go Negosyo, they provide free mentorship. When you get them outside, they charge very high. So you better join and take advantage of their expertise in Go Negosyo. And to all these distinguished speakers, Cebu Chamber of Commerce are a partner in mentoring. Pakitaas po ng kamay or stand up to be recognized. Nagpirmahan po kami at the back. To help again, Nonoy Espeleta there, professor and entrepreneur. And they'll be helping in the mentoring program to help Go Negosyo and DTI. Okay. You know, Go Negosyo po, for the past 11 years, started by Joey Concepcion, and we were all helping him and a host of other entrepreneurs and angelpreneurs have been promoting really a country of enterprising Filipinos. We want to create an entrepreneurship revolution. It has been the passion of each and every one of us to share the kind of mindset that one must have to become successful. To us, this is the real solution to poverty. Sabi nga namin dito sa pagpasok ng Duterte administration, sabi natin, change is coming. Now, change has come. But change should come from within. And it is really the change from within, especially starting with the mindset that can really propel each and every one of us to become successful in life. You know? And our mantra, especially here in the Department of Trade and Industry, is to have prosperity for all. Prosperity for all. If only one would dream for it and one would work hard for it, then we can really attain prosperity for all. Nung araw ang uso ay education for all, digital for all, now prosperity for all. And we're happy that Go Negosyo, DTI, the USC, US Embassy, so many groups are really partnering and sharing the same vision to promote entrepreneurship, kabuhayan, no? Trabaho at negosyo, which was also now a slogan that we have adopted in DTI, trabaho at negosyo. It's not about only creating jobs. We know in DTI, we've been, our vision is really to create a country of innovative, competitive enterprises. industries to create quality jobs and to have quality income for all Filipinos. But the reality is that there will always be an unemployment rate somewhere there. Even developed countries would have about 4% unemployment. For us now, we're about 6.6%. That's equivalent to about 2.5 million Filipinos. So, hindi lahat talaga magkakatrabaho. Now, what we're saying is, dun sa hindi magkatrabaho, you can still succeed in life. Be an entrepreneur. So, kung hindi trabaho, mag-umpisa ng negosyo. And tulad ng sinabi ni Father, talagang we should have an orientation to shift. And I think we're seeing that now, Father, after 11 years of Go Negosyo, DTI partnering together. The mindset now of many young entrepreneurs, young students especially, the young Filipinos, they're now starting to think about what business can I have? Now you can see students or even the young people being proud of the business that they're starting, di ba? A lot of food concepts, service-oriented concepts, spa, whatever negosyo, they're now proud. Look at my business. We're now developing a country of idea-based entrepreneurship. No? Did you notice that, especially in the more recent years? I think we're starting to enjoy a culture of entrepreneurship, and we're happy to see that. We're witnessing that. Before, when we talk of entrepreneurship, ay negosyo, nagne-negosyo, ay hindi kasi makahanap ng trabaho. So lahat ng nene-negosyo noon, di ba, nahihiya. Ah, pag tinanong mo, anong ginagawa po ninyo? Ito, nagne-negosyo lang, may kasamang kamot pa, no? Nahihiya. Ngayon hindi, no? I'm an entrepreneur. So very excited, and they'll be passionate about explaining their businesses. No? So we're happy to see that, but we should still do more of that. And that's why in Go Negosyo, they put up a Mentor Me program, and this time in partnership with the U.S. Embassy, pushing for innovation. It's not just an ordinary, it's easy to start a business. An ordinary business, you can buy, you can sell, but now we're talking of leveling up, always leveling up, putting innovation as the way to grow the business. Innovation is the heart of every growing enterprise. Innovation and creativity creates excitement on why people will buy your products. It is your unique value proposition that makes it attractive to your market. What makes you different and relevant that will make one buy your product? That's the core question of every entrepreneur. Yung parating, bakit bibili yung produkto ko? Whether it's an IT product, a software product, brick and mortar, food, whatever service, whatever negosyo, bakit sa akin bibili at hindi dun sa katabi? It sounds simple, a simple question, but that's a very difficult question to answer. Di ba? You will realize that question especially when sales are dropping. Bakit hindi na binibili produkto ko? No? Anong kailangan ko pang gawin? And that is where innovation comes in. This is the wonderful challenge that brings us together in this forum today. What kind of innovation should we bring? How can we level up? As part of the Go Negosyo, up to last month, okay, and very recent, I have always loved this program with the U.S. Embassy. Of selecting young enterprising individuals from around the country, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, with solid business concepts. So they were selected, hindi lang kahit sino yon. They had proposals for those wanting to start a concept or existing unique concepts. And they became participants to this Youth Entrepreneurship Development Workshop. They have unique, exciting concept, and yet, with the Youth Entrep Development Workshop, we challenge each one on how to innovate further, how to level up. With the help of Go Negosyo entrepreneurs, mentors, entrepreneurs who are innovative, and again, a million thanks to all of you, the business models of the young were further elevated. They were challenged to move up the innovation ladder to have greater differentiation and yet relevance to the market. Kasi it's so easy to innovate. What if it is not relevant? No? Hindi rin mabebenta yon. With this, I wish to congratulate the participants. Pwedeng tumayo yung mga participants who have been part of the YEDAW. Yan yung mga pogi at magaganda na, hello, mabuhay po kayo. Go Negosyo! Yay! Ngayon, sabihin na natin, DTI. All right. Okay. Thank you. So they were challenged to move up the innovation ladder, have a greater differentiation, and improve pa yung mga business models nila. No? allow me to push further the challenge, especially to the youth in this room. Every growing company must start to think of innovation with a heart. As I said at the start of my talk, innovation is the heart of every growing company. Companies that are admired, companies with super high valuation, companies that are built to last. What if I tweak a bit the phrase and say every growing company must start to think of innovation with a heart? Innovations for greater good, innovation with a purpose. We can look at innovation that attempts to solve not only market gaps, but social gaps. Could be environment, could be poverty, health issues, to name a few. Here are the examples, and in fact, I'm proud to present examples who were part of the Youth Entrepreneurship Development Workshop. From the Luzon area, we have the Capital. In fact, the Capital has been recognized in other fora and by other institutions. It's a social enterprise, a crowdfunding platform, which helps farmers get funds, and it's founded by a young Filipina who wants farmers to get the profit they actually deserve. The concept basically allows anyone who has purchasing power, who would like to invest, who can go, and they can go to the website capital.com to look at the farms to fund. So, founded by Rachel Davila, sumama rin sa Yedaw, and is now Forbes magazine 30, what's this, 30 successful entrepreneurs who are under 30, you know, in Asia. She founded the company after realizing the unmet need of Filipino farmers to gain capital. We actually dug deep into the agricultural problem here in the Philippines, and we found out that majority of the farmers are already too old and they live below the poverty line. And they are the ones producing our food, and yet they are the poorest, sabi ni Rachel. So sabi niya, so we've come up with a solution called Capital, wherein we will provide them funding, but also provide them support for them to improve their lives by improving their productivity as well. With the tagline, grow your money, help our farmers. Davila said, investment in the social enterprise is a win-win situation for both investors and the farmers. With the investors growing their money while the farmers earn big profit, Davila is inviting everyone to invest with a minimum of 5,000 pesos only in capital and gain a return of up to 30%. Up to 30%. The next example is from Visayas, our good friend Mariel. Please stand up, Mariel. Oh, yeah, nah. Oh, proud, ah, proud. Mariel May Obrego, kagagraduate lang, no? Congratulations. UP, correct, no? Winner of the Yedaw 2015 Visayas Leg Business Idea category. Mariel's business idea, Agriblocks. Naalala ko, pinesent ito when we were in Iloilo, no? Agriblocks builders, or simply Agriblocks, aims to address the high demands for hollow blocks and the increasing rate of agricultural waste. So, and this is in Tacloban. So, naalala nyo yung natamaan na Haiyan, no? Na typhoon. Agriblocks integrates the concept of green construction, where rice hull, na dumadaming mga ipa, rice hull ash, will be used as raw materials in the production of hollow blocks. So according to Mariel, unlike the traditional hollow blocks which are commercially sold, and this is according to DOST also, agri-blocks per study is proven to be stronger and lighter. Okay. So kung gusto nyong hanapin yon sa Go Negosyo blog on agri-blocks. And third example, human nature, probably common and familiar to many of us. So human nature started by the Gawad Kalinga volunteers, Camille, Meloto, Wilk, I'm sorry, siya yung Camille Meloto, Dylan Wilk and Anna Meloto Wilk, yan, who wanted to start a revolution of inclusive enterprises that promotes caring and restoring communities, centering on the core values of being pro-Philippines, pro-poor, and pro-environment, human nature began to develop effective, safe, and environmentally sustainable products from ingredients that can be grown locally. So ngayon, you can see now human nature being distributed even in the mainstream supermarkets and malls. No? And again, they source raw materials from communities around human nature and also GK or Gawad Kalinga communities. Then, an example, a very good example from the University of San Carlos. Okay, turning waste into gold. You, nandito ba ang mga proponents ito or the faculty? Kung nandito po, can you please stand up and be recognized, the faculty and the students behind this project? Palakpakan po natin sila. USC students participated in research under the tutelage and guidance of Professor Taboada. The waste produced from processed dried mangoes have been transformed to product categories for our local and global markets. Into a story of great collaboration of academe, industry, community, and government. The USC owns and operates the biorefinery plant called Bioprocess Engineering Research Center and is one of the partner universities of IPO Philippines in its Innovation and Technology Support Office program. The plant reprocesses the dried mango waste for a variety of products such as mango, flour, harina, no, butter, and tea, as well as ingredients like pectin and pyrophenol for the cosmetic industry. So it's like a biotechnology kind of technology that can be converted into high value and relevant products. So BioPRC developed a novel way to recover the beneficial elements of mango waste and to convert it into high value products. BioPRC researchers Dr. Taboada and Dr. Siakor filed a patent application with the IPO Philippines in 2012, etc. On the strength of these applications, the university has entered into a joint venture with a local investor to create a small startup company, Green Enviro Management Systems, which has an exclusive license to use the process and produce products for a wider range of applications in food, pharmaceutical, personal care, and energy industries. So let me end. Success and greatness is not about richness. It's not about titles. It starts when we show concern for others and when we change people's lives. Good morning and magandang umaga po. Maayong buntag sa inyong lahat.